Let's look at the symptoms of coronary heart disease, right? Because there are a lot of symptoms, and the first one we know, of course, is tightness in the in the chest. That's when you see, you know, in the movies, right?
Yes,
people having that feeling. Now, just so we know, because I think sometimes people don't know when this is happening, right?
Right.
They might think that they have like some little acid reflux or something. Like,
absolutely.
How do you know the difference?
It can be very hard to know the difference, Cynthia, to be honest. And, you know, when in doubt, assume the worst is a reasonable maxim. But tightness or pressure in the chest that does not go away quickly with rest or that is severe, especially when it is related to exertion, those are very classic signs and symptoms of heart disease. Exertional symptoms, such as shortness of breath, weakness, and fatigue, these can also be signs of decreased blood flow to the heart muscle and angina. And it's very common, although not essential, that the discomfort that you feel in your chest can radiate to the jaw, to the neck, and to the back.
So you're gonna feel all of those, or you could just feel one or two, or is it?
Many people can feel just one or two, and very often for a particular patient, their symptom is going to be their symptom for life. So let's say someone's had a heart attack, they presented with chest tightness, felt like an elephant sitting on my chest doc. We take care of the problem, they have heart surgery, put them on medicine, they get a stent, then 6 months later they say, you know, doc, I had a different pain, it was a sharp pain, it went away in seconds, is that my heart too? And usually I'll tell them, your heart generally will give you the same signal for the same problem. So everyone will have different symptoms, but generally your symptoms for angina, if you ever have it, will be the same throughout the course of your life.